He leaves, without saying another word.
"You can get dressed now," says Matron.
Mother pulls a dress over her head.
"Who was the man who brought us here?" "Mr. James is the relieving officer. Nobody gets in without seeing him first."
Ginny's none the wiser, but he sounds important. Matron takes them to a room called the receiving ward, a room full of beds where people have to wait until their case is put to the Board of Guardians, and they're allowed entry into the workhouse.
"You're lucky your case is being considered tomorrow, because there isn't another meeting until next week,"
she says, bustling away. A bell will sound for supper, someone in workhouse clothes tells them. Most of the beds are full of women, and many have little ones. Some can't stop crying. Ginny huddles against Mother on the bed. At least they're together. She only hopes that Father is coping on his own.
"How is it possible for an afternoon to last so long?"
When the bell finally rings, the ward is full to overflowing. They follow a woman with a loud mouth who seems to know where she's going.
"Expect nothing and you'll not be disappointed," she says to anybody listening.
Ginny gets into line and stares at the feet of the woman in front, waiting for her turn to move. Slowly, the line shunts forward. The inmates are already seated as Ginny's group arrives in the huge dining hall. There are no men. Matron bangs a piece of wood on the table. The chattering stops. She puts her hands together to say grace, and when it's over, spoons hit metal bowls. Nobody speaks until every bowl is licked clean. Kids a lot younger than Ginny cry and ask for more. She tries to eat, but gags on the smell of something that looks like broth before it reaches her mouth.